Racing to the 2020 Preakness Stakes and the 2020 Breeders' Cup. Let's get you up to date here for a Wednesday. And lots of news going on over the weekend for Preakness workouts. Swiss Skydiver worked out 4 furlongs. It looks like the filly could be racing against the boys, possibly in the Preakness Stakes. Art Collector had a good 4-furlong workout, galloped out a mile, and he seems to be recovering from that foot injury that knocked him out of the Kentucky Derby. So Art Collector most likely to go next in the Preakness and get that matchup with Authentic, the Kentucky Derby winner. Also, other workouts. Country Grammar's been working out steadily since his last race in the Travers, and it'll be interesting to see if Chad Brown elects to run Country Grammar in the Preakness Stakes at Old Hilltop or maybe one of the undercard races, because he's been working out pretty steadily since that Travers Stakes and losing to Tis the Law. Other workouts for the Breeders' Cup. That filly division continues to be strong. Midnight Bassoo continues to train towards the Spinster Stakes. We also have the winner of Monomoy Girls, Churchill Downs winner last out. She has had a nice workout, so she continues to train well for her 2020 campaign, where she's 3-for-3. And then Vexatious off that last loss at Churchill Downs. Of course, the big win over Midnight Bassoo before that at Saratoga. So she continues to train, possibly in the Spinster Stakes, or she already has the win and you're in for the Breeders' Cup Distaff. Wanted to take a look at the Dirt Mile contenders. We previewed the Classic contenders and the Sprint contenders, and a lot of those horses are under consideration for the Breeders' Cup Dirt Mile. But one of them who we didn't talk about is Win Win Win. He continues to come out of that forego well. He's got lots of options, including training up to the Dirt Mile. But I think that mile is going to suit him perfectly, as he's got a couple of nice wins at 7 furlongs. He can come from off the pace. He proved he can win in an off track in the slop the last time out in the forego. I think Owendale could be pointed for that Breeders' Cup mile. He worked out 4 furlongs and 47-2 for Brad Cox over the weekend. He probably is going to prefer the mile to a mile and eighth distance. Of course, he had that big Remington Park victory last year, Owendale. Disappointed in a couple of races this year, but picked it up a second place finish out the last time out in the Alishiba. I thought they might go to the Jockey Club Gold Cup, but I think the mile might be a better option for Owendale. Improbable off the back-to-back mile and a quarter victories. He could also maybe cut back to the mile if Bob Baffert doesn't want to run three of them in the Classic, but most likely Improbable going to point towards that Breeders' Cup Classic. And then you've got the horses like Vekoma. He can run in either the Sprint or the Dirt Mile. You've got Mr. Freeze, who continues to work out. He faded last time out in the Alishiba after setting some fast fractions. I think Dale Romans is going to point him for the Dirt Mile. So Mr. Freeze, definitely the son of To Honor and Serve, could definitely be in that Dirt Mile. And Frenzy Fire, he's kind of alternated between the Sprints at 7 furlongs and a mile. Seems like this year he doesn't have that raw speed anymore. I think he could be another contender for that Dirt Mile for Frenzy Fire. So as we get closer now, under 45 days to the Breeders' Cup, of course the Preakness Stakes coverage will continue on. We're going to have some undercard selections, a betting show on that Saturday, and then a Preakness preview coming up next week. We're also going to take a look at the top contenders and really deep dive it this coming weekend for that Preakness Stakes. Remember, hit subscribe as we continue to lead you up to the Breeders' Cup and the Preakness Stakes. Share this video with all your horse racing friends and ring that bell for notifications as we lead you up to the 2020 Breeders' Cup.